Okay, I guess everyone is here. A great morning to each and everyone. Happy Monday and welcome to our English class. So, how was your weekend, guys? Oh, that's good to hear. Oh, that's great. Well, as for me, I just stayed at home, watched some Netflix, and did my household works. Okay, so, So let me check the attendance first. Okay, let me see who is absent here. Okay, so everybody is present and on time. Very good, everyone. Thank you for being punctual and diligent in this class. So I hope that you will stay consistent throughout the end of the school year. Okay, so here I am showing you our goals for this lesson. What are we going to achieve at the end of this lesson? Okay, first, use the appropriate and effective speech conventions in poetry reading. Second, use antonyms to arrive at the meaning of words. Third, compare and contrast information listened to. We also have draw generalizations and conclusions from the materials viewed. And then show appreciation for the significant human experiences highlighted and shared during the discussion or presentation. And lastly, write a poetry about your philosophy and life. So before proceeding to our main lesson, let us have a pre-activity first to get you engaged in our lesson for today. Are you ready? Okay. So what we are going to do is that we will be listening to a very inspiring song entitled Fight Song by Rachel Platten. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the song, and you are also welcome to sing along if you know the song, okay? Okay. Okay, so can you see my screen? Okay.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time?
Okay, woo. That song is really intense. It hits right into our heart. Right, class? Do you also feel the same way? Okay, woo. Okay, so let me ask you, what do you think the song is all about? Yes, that's right. It is a song that tells us not to give up in life, no matter what heartbreak or consequences or challenges that we will face in our lives. We should always fight, fight, fight. Okay. So what we are going to do now is to answer these questions after listening to an inspiring song. Okay, so please read and answer number one. Okay, yes, Jane. Very good. It makes us feel brave and strong about life. It makes us feel powerful that we could overcome all obstacles that we face in life. How about number two? Yes, Leo. Oh, that's good to hear. Everyone here in our class has different challenges in life, but there's one thing, one common thing among us, and that is we learn to stand up and never give up. Number three. Yes, Anna. That's right. We should always ask for God's guidance in every path that we take in life. Lastly, number four. Yes, Vincent. Yeah. All of us here wants to know why we are alive, especially for you, my students. As for me, I think I already know what my purpose here in my life. And that is to mold your generation into becoming the best that you can be for your future and for the future of this world. Okay, so now we are not yet finished. So we still need, or we still have to play a game called Four Picks, One Word. So I know that you all are familiar with this game, right? Okay, so let's go. So those who want to answer, please raise your hand. Okay. So guess the word. What do you think the word is here? Yes, Enrico. Mournful. Let's see if you got the correct answer. Very good. The answer is mournful. How about this? What do you think is the answer? Yes, Shane. Can anyone help Shane? Yes, Riza. Fleeting. Let's check. Correct. The answer is fleeting. How about this one? The view looks so breathtaking, right? Yes, Henry. Sublime. Let's see. Correct. The answer is sublime. Number four. What do you think is the word? Look at them. They look so sad and lonely. Yes, JB. Forlorn. Let's check. Very good. The answer is forlorn. Last but not the least. This one's easy. Okay, it's only four letters. The answer is, everyone, fate. The answer is fate, correct. So very good, everyone, for being so participative. Give yourselves a round of applause. So you will encounter these words in our lesson for today. So now we are all ready to dive into our main lesson, which is all about A Psalm of Life by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. So this is a poetry class. I will read it while you can follow me through the lines. Read with your eyes only, okay? Tell me not in mournful numbers. Life is but an empty dream, for the soul is dead that slumbers, and things are not what they seem. Life is real, life is earnest, and the grave is not its goal. Dust thou art, to dust returnest, was not spoken of the soul. not enjoyment, not sorrow, is our destined end or way. But to act that each tomorrow finds us farther than today. Art is long and time is fleeting, and our hearts, though stout and brave, still, like muffled drums, are beating funeral marches to the grave. In the world's broad field of battle, in the bivouac of life, be not like dumb, driven cattle, be a hero in the strife. Trust no future, however pleasant, let the dead past bury its dead. Act, act in the living present, heart within and God overheard. Lives of great men all remind us, we can make our lives sublime, and departing, leave behind us footprints on the sands of time. Footprints that perhaps another, sailing over life, solemn mien of our Lord and shipwrecked brother, seeing shall take heart again. Let us then be up and doing, with a heart for any fate, still achieving, still pursuing, learn to labor and to wait. So there, that ends the poetry. It's heartwarming, isn't it, class? Yes. So while reading the poem, I felt so thankful for everything as we went through it. Okay, so class, let me ask you, do you find this poem interesting? Right. It's very interesting and heartwarming. So now, let us understand the poem a little bit deeper by answering these questions. Okay? So for those who will want to participate, you will be given stars that will serve as plus points in this class. Okay? That's good, right? Okay, so if you want to answer, please raise your hand. Okay, how about number one? Read and answer. Yes, Jane. Yes, very good. I feel the same way too. The poem makes us very appreciative about life. How about number two? Yes, Andrew. Correct. The poem is all about life or the purpose of our lives. Number three, any other hands? Yes, Ben. That's right. The last stanza of the poem tells us to learn to wait because it will all be worth it if we are patient but also hardworking. How about number four? Yes, April. Very good analysis. It's not death that is our destined end, but for us to find our purpose here in our lives is what makes our lives worth living. Our destiny on who and what we will be in this life. Okay, number five. Correct. A man is someone who learns about his past and failures and do great in the future. Lastly, number six. Very good. The seventh stanza in the poem tells us that to become a man, one should not forget about his past, yet he should learn from it and grow from it. Okay. So now I would like to know if you have identified and learned values and lessons while reading the poetry. So what is one value that you learned from the poem, A Psalm of Life? And why do you think this value makes life more meaningful? Okay, let's ask Miss Rachel. Okay, thank you, Rachel. So I have here three values that we could get from the poem, A Psalm of Life. So first is patience. Patience puts us in direct control of ourselves. When we are patient, we give ourselves time to choose how to respond to a given event rather than get emotionally hijacked by our emotions. It also allows us to stay gathered no matter what is happening around us. Next is optimism. An optimistic attitude helps us be more happier, successful, and healthier. So optimism can protect us against depression, even for people who are at risk. An optimistic outlook in life makes people more resistant to stress, and optimism may also help us to live longer. Okay, last is hard work. If you will work hard, then you will be able to achieve all of your goals and fulfill all your dreams. So working hard with full determination always pushes us one step ahead in life and helps us surpass our limitations. Right, class? Okay. Now, what do you think is the main idea of the poem? Let's ask Gerald. Thank you, Gerald. So, A Psalm of Life carries a message of hope and encouragement. It encourages people to live their lives to the fullest, using the short time we have here on earth as a gift. The poem is a message to future generations to find work and action that gives them purpose and passion. So, class, do whatever makes you happy. But make sure that you are not hurting other people with what you do. Okay? Okay. All right. So now I will be dividing you into 5 groups because we will be doing a group activity. So we will have fun while learning. Okay. Let's see. So, do you believe that Longfellow has a strong view about life? How does Longfellow's view of life compare with your own view? So, let us know how similar or different your views are compared to Longfellow's view about life by answering this activity with your group. We have here Longfellow's view and then your own personal view. So, you are now divided into groups. I'll give you 15 minutes to work on your groups, and after that, you will present your work in front of the class, okay? Okay, you may start now. So it's already past 15 minutes. I believe that all groups are now ready to present their works. Okay, let's start with group 1, then 2, 3, and so on. Okay, thank you so much, everyone, for delivering excellent presentations. So a big round of applause to everyone. Okay, thank you so much. So since you all have presented your philosophy in life, this time you are going to transform it into poetry. So this will be an individual work. Okay, write a poetry about your own philosophy in life. The following elements should be present in the poem. First, it should contain a title. Then it should contain 3 stanzas with 4 lines each stanza. And the theme should be about life. And lastly, it could be in free verse or with rhythmic pattern. So, any more questions? Yes, write your poetry using Microsoft Word and submit it in the assignment channel that I provided in our Teams, okay? Okay, you may now begin. Okay, so I guess everyone has submitted their poetry. Okay, so good job, everyone. So by this time, let us see how much you have learned from our discussion, okay? So we will be having two seat words. So first is task one, multiple choice, and task two will require you to search for the antonym. So I have posted the link of our seat works in our Teams, and you just have to click it to open the Google Forms. Okay, so I'll give you 15 minutes to answer, and later on, we'll check your answers. Okay, you may now begin. Okay, so time is up. I guess everyone has submitted their seat works. And now we will check if you got the correct answers. Okay, let's start with task one. So can you read an answer, Avery? Correct. The answer is letter B. How about number two? Read an answer, Ashton. Correct. The answer is letter C right here. How about the third question? Can you read an answer, Tim? Very good. The answer is letter A. How about this one? Can you read an answer, Joshua? Correct. The answer is letter D. And finally, can you read an answer, Hans? Correct. The answer is letter B. So now let's proceed to task two. So what were you supposed to do in task two again? Correct. So you have to search for the antonyms of these words, which can be found in the poem, A Psalm of Life. So first we have ordinary. The answer is sublime. Two, harmony. The answer is strife. Who got this correct? Okay. So third is ridiculous. The answer is solemn. Next, failing. The answer is achieving or pursuing. Number five, awake. The answer is slumber. How about number six? Cheerful. The answer is forlorn. Number seven, moves. The answer is departing. Number eight, insincere. The answer is earnest. Number nine, slender. The answer is stout. And lastly, permanent. The answer is fleeting. So very good, everyone. Big hands to yourselves for doing a great job. So did you all have fun during our discussion and activities? And while having fun, did you learn a lot too? Okay, I'm glad to hear that, and I am proud of you. So thank you so much. So before we'll end our class today, I have an assignment for you, okay? So recall another poem that you have encountered before in class that you find interesting. So compare the poem with A Psalm of Life by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. Compare the specific points that are similar enough to enable you to draw effective comparison. So plot your answers in the chart that follows. Okay, so you have to find a poem, okay? Or you have to recall a poem that you have already encountered. So here is the chart. We have here the first column, poem one, then poem two, then the title of poem, the subject, or what is it about, then the mood or tone, and the theme. So do you have any other questions about the assignment? Okay, I believe there is none. All right, so how about for the lesson? Do you have any more questions before we'll go? Okay, so thank you, class, for being here today and for being so participative and for doing a great job. So see you next time and goodbye. Goodbye, class. Goodbye, everyone.